You've definitely seen dynamic captions like these on social media videos. Let me show you how you can get this effect by just dragging and dropping with Camtasia. To follow along with this one, it's time for an upgrade. Make sure you've got your hands on the latest version of Camtasia. You can find a link in the description, and let's dive in. Whether you filmed with your phone, camera, or Camtasia Rev, add your footage to the timeline. You can add captions to the raw footage and make edits that will bring your captions along for the ride throughout the process. But for my workflow, I'm gonna wait until I've made all of my edits to make this as simple as possible. Mac users will see a new asset bin on the left, but it's been there all along on Windows, the captions bin. If your Camtasia window is smaller, you may have to click the More button to find it. You can now also reorder these tabs by clicking and dragging so you can make the most frequently used ones easier to find. Inside the captions bin, there are two tabs, one for captions, but we want the other one, dynamic captions. You'll see a variety of options. I'm gonna grab the second one and drop it on the track above my footage. Longer clips will obviously take more time to process, but shorter videos should be done pretty quickly. Camtasia shows you that it's transcribing on the audio clip, and when it's done, boom, you've got dynamic captions. By default, the caption track is a set duration, and it most likely won't be as short or as long as your video, so make sure to trim it or extend it out as needed. There are a ton of customization options. Click on the caption track to open the text properties panel so you can make some changes. The highlighting dropdown determines if you want to highlight the word being said or just leave the entire line of text to appear motionless on screen, similar to standard captioning. Speaking of which, we do recommend one line at a time as a best practice, but if you feel that you should have more, you can grab the text bounding box on the canvas and stretch it upward to reveal more text lines. But in this video, I'm gonna keep it to just one line of captions. While we're talking about the canvas, even though most of our callouts are edited there, if you wanna combine, delete, or edit the words in the caption, click the audio track and make your edits under the caption transcription section in the bin. There are multiple ways to swap out styles. I find it easiest to just drag the new style on top of the one already in the timeline, hover over it until it turns green, and select Replace, which will retain the duration. You can also just delete one and put a new one on the timeline. The nice thing about captions being attached to the audio track is even after deleting my captions and replacing them with a new style, any edits I've made to the text are still there. All right, let's get back into the properties. The word color is obvious. Stroke color allows you to change the color of the text outline. I'll customize mine to be purple, but look at this one. You can change the opacity of the words to the left and right of the highlight by adjusting future and past opacities, keeping your viewer focused on what you're saying now, not what you just said or are about to say. You can add more emphasis to your highlighted word by adding a background behind it, really focusing your viewer's attention. Choose a color, adjust the opacity of the shape, size it up or down with scale, or soften the corners with the radius slider. Time determines if your shape will have abrupt cuts between each word, three features inside of Camtasia's, or if the shape will show a smooth motion as it slides across your caption. Features inside of Camtasia's dynamic. Play around with this to find the style that you like best. Another favorite slider for me is the advanced scale option to size up your highlighted word so it appears to pop out of the caption track as it's being said. After you've made your changes, you may look at this caption and go, wow, this is it. This is the one I want to use from now on, but I don't want to customize it each time. You don't have to. At the top of the properties panel, click the plus button and name your new style. It saves in your dynamic captions bin. You can even star it so it's easy to find with all of your other favorites. Maybe the opposite is true. You made way too many changes and just want to go back. No need to delete and drag it back down again. Just hit the reset arrow at the top of the properties panel to go back to your default settings. If you're on Windows, you'll be excited to hear about one more feature inside the latest build. With all of this amazing advancement in Camtasia's new AI transcription engine, we now have speech-to-text captioning. Want to record your narration and have it transcribed at the same time? In the captions bin, go back over to the regular captions tab, click on the gear icon up top, and choose speech-to-text. This feature will be coming soon to Mac. I really hope you find dynamic captions to be the missing piece that takes your content creation game to the next level. Tell us in the comments what you think about dynamic captions. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe to our channel so you know when we release more great content. Thanks for watching.